You know, whiskey is actually clear when it comes off the still. Gets the caramel color from the...
You know, I'm just gonna say this. Sometimes it feels like it doesn't even matter that I'm sitting here. I know all the places you've lived. I know all the languages you speak. I've met your exes, your baby mamas, your spawn. And yet, you have never asked one question about me. Did you know that I became legal guardian of my siblings when I was 23? Or that I dropped out of high school, but then I went back and I got my GED?
Yes, actually, I did. And I know you did it to convince your genius brother, who's a recovering alcoholic, to stay in college. I know you got left at the altar by your junkie fiancé, with whom you were very much in love.
How?
Because I ask around. Here's some other stuff I know. You're fiercely protective of your family, you're generous. Like today, for example, you gave your apartment to a homeless family. You are so very much yourself. You don't even have to try. And frankly, you scare the fucking shit out of me. Where are you thinking of going?
Haven't been much anywhere.
And go to the airport. Get on whatever international flight's taking off next. Leave it to fate.
You coming with me?
You want me to?
That's not an answer.
Okay, then, sure.
I don't know what this is.
This?
Us.
What do you want it to be?
You really have to stop answering my questions with a question.
Is that bothering you, is it?
What should I say when I talk about you to other people?
Tell them whatever you want.
Am I your girlfriend?
Do you want to be my girlfriend?
Are you sleeping with anybody else?
No. I'd tell you before that happened. I'm happy with what this is. But I'm willing to make adjustments if you let me know what you want.
I want you to be madly in love with me.
I'm not 17 years old. I don't fall madly in love with people anymore.
How much did you win in your last fight? Or was it just a feud thing?
That's your way of impressing me. You reckon I'll go all chilly because you deduced that bare-knuckle fight?
Broken 51 times. Grew back wonky.
Anyone can see.
Not too many ways that happens past punching things without gloves on.
In my less than posh Irish background points to bare-knuckle clan fighting. My still pretty face as I usually win.
You're no smarter than me, super detective.
You're an angry guy, Tommy. It's gonna get in your way.
She called you for your birthday.
She's my nanny. She always calls me for my birthday.
But your parents haven't. I've been waiting for the last 2 days, no one else called.
Very busy. They're important people with important jobs.
Sienna.
We don't really make a big deal of the birthdays of my family anyway.
Sienna. All I'm saying is it doesn't matter that they haven't called. All our families are messed up. All I'm trying to say is cheers. Cheers and happy birthday.
This was supposed to be Joe.
It was always supposed to be you. Are you ready?
How's it going in there, Kenny? It's close. We knew it would be. It's gonna come down to Illinois, Texas, and California.
Well, we're gonna need Texas.
They want to perform an autopsy.
I'm not leaving without him, Kenny. We have to take him home.
I know.
They can't have him. I'm taking my husband home with me.
Okay, we'll call a mortuary. We'll get a casket. We can get someone to bring you a change of clothes from the plane.
No. No. I want them to see what they've done to Jack.
But this is a place for a family.
And we'll fill it with one. Look at me. You will have children. I promise you.
We'll build a house right there.
Be a den at the end of the garden. With a treehouse for the kids. And for you, I'll build a hot tub.
A hot tub? Is that the best you can do?
I was going to say kitchen, but I reckon hot tub was probably better.
I reckon right.
It's going to be perfect. Trust me.
Don't move.
Move around a lot. I think there's more of us than there is.
That's your plan?
That's as good as it gets.
Lower your weapons and stand down!